Hello, welcome back to my channel, you guys. I'm Jess from Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. Hopefully the wind isn't going to be too much of a distraction. For some reason, it is beautiful out, but there's a gusty wind that's going on that is sporadic and spontaneous and strong, but still it's beautiful out. Also, this video is brought to you by my Hufflepuff mug. Not really, but I just wanted to showcase it. I got it from Marshall's for those of you guys that ask me about it, or any mug that it is I have. Marshall's is a gold mine when it comes to mugs. No, they're not sponsoring this video, I wish. Anyways, let's go ahead and talk about this full moon in the sign of Virgo, shall we? First and foremost, on a more selfish note, you guys know that I'm a Virgo, and I live for full moon energy, always and forever. Even before I even understood it, I always would look up at the stars and the skies as a child and feel so at home and so content under the light of a full moon. And I would always count my moments to the next full moon. Something about it always vibed with me. It always resonated with me. So these are moments now that I understand why I was so called to them and why it was so special to me. And I'm now, years later, able to kind of uncode and reveal what makes that moment and that time so special and be able to share it with you guys. But it just goes to show you guys that we feel these things. We feel these things innately. We feel them intuitively. We're pulled to it. We're drawn to it. So this full moon is very, very special. And not just because it's Virgo energy, but because honestly, I feel like so many of us, the majority of us, have been through a lot, not just this year. At the time of me filming this, it's March 9th, 2020. This year has been filled with so many ripe moments that have been emotionally intense, mentally intense, spiritually intense already. I can't tell you how many times I've received a comment or a question or a DM being like, Jess, what the hell is going on? I thought this was a new year, new me type of energy. And that's the thing, is that astrology, the planets, they don't go in alignment with our timetable. They're doing what they're going to do regardless. And that's one thing that you have not seen me say, is that I was gonna promise an easy and effortless trip. We were still completing the energy of what had already kind of culminated from last year and also the year before that. So this is not only 2020 that we're dealing with, but 2019 and 2018 energy. All of that is still, we're kind of sorting through all of it. This full moon though feels very special. I'll explain to you why. I have the chart pulled up in front of me, and I also have my notes on the side. So for those of you guys that don't know, not only am I using my study of astrology and my intuitive gifts separately outside of astrology, but I merge both of those worlds together. The symbols trigger certain images and messages, and those things are things that I'm able to provide over to you. So this is a combination of both of those things. I write them down so that I don't forget it, so that I don't miss it. And this also allows me to share additional things that come through. So the first thing that's standing out to me, like obviously we know, for the majority of us, we do know that Virgo is the sign of being of service, and it's our work towards others or our work with others. But more than that, the time of this full moon, this is bringing a lot of things into culmination. It's all of what we've been absorbing and not only consuming, but digesting. So I feel I'm getting this like sense of certain things that it is that we're trying on, certain relationships, certain habits, certain lifestyles, different projects, certain things that we're taking on. And it's not until we digest it that we can see and determine, does this make me feel good? Does this make me feel strong? Does this make me feel weak? And at that point, you'll either have, just like if you had a certain food that doesn't agree with you, like you can have indigestion, you could have, maybe it just blasts out of you. This is such an awful metaphor, but it's a good metaphor, right? So it just depends on how it vibes with you, and everybody is different as far as what they are drawn to consume and when they consume it, how their body adjusts to it. So this is not only physical. I don't want you guys to look at this and be like, okay, well, let me, Jess is talking about what it is that I eat, so let me just focus on that. Mm-mm. This is physically, this is mentally, what it is that you're hearing, what you're consuming, the music that you're listening to, the podcast that you're listening to, the things that you're allowing your body to absorb. Spiritually, what your spiritual practice looks like, and also emotionally, those things that you allow to kind of bleed into the essence of who you are and how it impacts you, and does it vibe well? the beauty of this full moon is it's not up to just you to decide. You know what I mean by this? Let me kind of like break it down a little bit. So sometimes when we have a full moon, all of these things get brought to a head. All of the energy of all that has been building up for the last 28 days now comes to a head. And sometimes it's not even just the 28 days, but it could be months before or a year before. So all of those things come to a head. And then with that, something exposes itself, something reveals itself, and it's your responsibility, your job to see it, observe it, and do with it what you will. Well, this full moon, I'm getting a lot of support. It feels like you are being, all of us are being very much supported in what is kind of prevailing. I don't know why prevailing, but what is I don't know why I'm using the word prevail, but why, what comes to the surface? What is most eye-catching for you or energy-catching? It's the one thing that strikes you, I don't know, as odd or as obvious, something that it is that you can't ignore. And what happens is this full moon is sitting directly conjunct, well, the sun is sitting directly conjunct Neptune. And Neptune is this higher octave. It takes our feelings, our normal vibrations, our normal sensitivities, and takes it to the next level. So we can feel certain things that we normally wouldn't have felt, and we can feel, not only are we energetically feeling it, but we're intuitively being called, like, okay, this doesn't vibe right with me. This is what I feel intuitively like I should, what I should do with this. This is what I feel called to do. And all you have to do is respond to that. So do you see the difference between this full moon and the other full moons? The majority of the other full moons, it's almost like you're kind of in it on your own to kind of go into that space in order to find out, okay, how does this vibe with me? How does this resonate? Is this good? Is this right? And then flip it at this time, it's almost like, okay, we're going to give you the information. We are going to tell you, we're going to give you hints and clues, and not even hints and clues, but an obvious, okay, this is a no or this is a yes, and do with it this. So it feels very, a lot of support. It doesn't feel like you're left to your own devices when it comes to moving forward and what this full moon will reveal to you. So that's the thing too about full moons, is that they will reveal information. They will reveal facts. They will, this is when you get a phone call or you feel something so strongly within your spirit that you can't ignore it anymore. The only thing that you can do is respect it and take it for what it is, and then do with it what you will. And hopefully your moves, your action are from a higher space, that you're not getting triggered by things and falling into lower vibrational energy and just kind of reacting to certain stuff. So especially with Mercury retrograde at the time of this full moon, Mercury moving backwards and now back into the sign of Aquarius, this is revisiting those old past conversations. And Aquarius is known to be connected to the 11th house, which is connected to hopes and wishes. When we look at this, you guys, hopes and wishes is not the things that it is that we're hoping for or striving for. I almost want to call it the house of expectations. It's what you expect, and hopefully you're expecting the best and you're not expecting the worst for yourself, and then succumbing to this, like, I don't say negative energy, but like locked up, closed up energy. So when Mercury is now retrograde and moving back to the sign of Aquarius at the time of the full moon, because it's the entire chart that it is that I'm looking at, this is when you revisit those expectations that it is that you have for yourself, this bigger vision, this larger than life vision, and help to almost work to kind of patch certain things together in order to change your outcome, in order to help change your outcome. This is why this full moon is so special, because it really can change the course of your life. And I think, like, when people are trying to make like big, when people are trying to make like lifestyle changes, they focus so much on the bigger things, the things that are so obvious, but the more that you look at them, the more that they feel almost overwhelming. And so when you look at that, you realize, okay, there's this huge obstacle that it is that I need to take care of. There's this huge thing that it is that I need to take care of. And it feels very like overwhelming before you can even get started. So basically what is happening here at the time of this full moon is that this full moon is saying, we don't want you to hyper focus on this bigger picture. We actually want you to focus on your day to day, your routine, your hygiene, meaning like, not just like how you physically take care of your body, like are you brushing your teeth at night, are you showering? These are things that most people do in order to maintain a high level of, you know, good hygiene. And without those things, it can be detrimental to your health, and it can also be detrimental to your relationships. Like, people don't want to talk to you if you haven't brushed your teeth in 3 weeks. Like, that's a problem, right? So the same thing is true when it comes to your spiritual hygiene, your mental hygiene, your emotional hygiene. How are you taking care of those smaller things that seem minute and seem insignificant but are very important to your overall well-being? So you have all of these hints in the chart suggesting towards, sorry for the alarms, you guys. Like I said, I'm outside, the wind is blowing. I'm in the city, it's beautiful out here, but at the same time it can be kind of noisy. But like I said, you have all of these, you know, these like signals, these little pings, that's what it is I'm gonna call it. Almost like cell phone towers. This chart that I'm looking at right now is lit up like a cell phone tower, where you have one major signal kind of pinging to these smaller things, and you can track your growth and your progress. And it's almost showing you the way. It's almost lighting up the way for you. The vision that it is that I'm getting, because you guys know I get visions all the time, but the vision that it is that I'm getting is like a person who is studying for a test. You know what I mean? Like a major test. And they've been studying, and their hygiene when it comes to this is every day they took out 30 minutes to study, to do practice quiz questions, or to do flip cards, or whatever it is that whatever tools they're using in order to hit their goal, this larger picture that they see for themselves, this grander picture, this expectation that they have that they're gonna pass this test and become a whatever. Right? So their hygiene is in these smaller tools that they're using in order to hit their goal, in order to achieve their goal. And they are more likely to succeed because of these smaller tasks that feel good to them. Now, everybody has different learning abilities. Everybody has different learning styles. So, and then everybody has different levels of what they can achieve with that, and different levels of different types of intelligences. So not everybody is one type of intelligence. So there's a lot of wiggle room, and you have to find what works for you. When we have a chart like this, that is the same thing as happening in your life at the time of this full moon, is that it says, listen, these are some tools and some resources that you've tried in the past. These are some things that you have done in your relationship. When you did that, did it feel good? Did it feel bad? Were you able to digest it? When you digested it, did it feel like it nourished the relationship? Did it nourish your projects? Did it nourish your study? Or did you have a hard time swallowing it? Did you have a hard time digesting it? Did it explode out of you? Back to that awful metaphor. And if it doesn't work for you, follow your vibes, listen to that intuition, and I want you to try this. This method is going to help you, and it's going to create more success. So not only is this hygiene, and as far as like how is that you're physically taking care of yourself with your body, meaning like your diet, your workout routine, your sleep hygiene, those types of things, but it's also spiritually, it's also emotionally within your relationships, romantic, platonic, and your family relationships, all types of relationships. All of those things are under the light of this full moon getting, I'm gonna call it scrutinized, but I don't want you to feel like you're under a magnifying glass. I just feel like the universe sees your highest potential and wants you to achieve that highest potential. So it's giving you the tools and the resources to maximize that so that you can hit your own personal growth. So that is a lot to receive. Also, there's one last thing that it is I want to talk about, because you guys know I can be very thorough with these readings. The fact that Venus conjunct Uranus is happening here, but that all by itself is so special and unique, and it can really create like a flip coin of, you know, goodness, right? And not even a flip coin, but let's say if it's a coin that has a bunch of different sides to it. So let's say it has like 15 or 13 different sides. It's like a grab bag. Like, what is it when you put your hand in this bag? What type of coin, what type of gift or reward are you gonna pull out of it? You know, it's pretty much left to fate, or it's up to your chart, which is also fated, right? So when we have Venus conjunct Uranus here at the time of this full moon, basically what we're having is a unveiling, a peeling back of the layers of this onion to reveal a specific truth, a specific tool, a specific reward, something that it is that you want to strive towards, that you want to see yourself attain to be, something that you want to see yourself feeling every day. Like I said before, I'm gonna rewind just a little bit, is that sometimes we have this bigger picture of, this is the life that it is that I wanna live. I wanna be able to travel, I wanna be in Bali, I wanna fly to Tahiti, I want to work remotely, all of these things. That's that bigger picture. But it's those smaller details that it is that this chart is suggesting that they want you to focus on. So in your day-to-day, sure, there's the travel, but like, what are you eating? How is that nourishing your body? Like the food that it is that you're eating, what are you listening to help you, to encourage you every day? What, how are you staying active? How are you staying happy? What do your relationships look like? Pay attention to those smaller details, because as we move you to this larger vision of what it is that you see for yourself, you still need to be fulfilled. You still need to be happy with the status quo, because that is also going to help you to get to that bigger picture, but it's also going to help you to enjoy the moment and your life, because you only have one life to live and it should be a great one. Right? Comment down below if you feel like you are ready to live the best life that you could possibly imagine for yourself, because I do. I'm gonna leave a comment down as well. But yeah, when it comes to Venus and Uranus in the sign of Taurus, again, this is about very tangible. This is not just in the cosmos, in your vision of, you know, your higher vision that it is that you have for yourself, this picture that it is that you see for yourself. This is very much here, present now, in this moment, what you can experience, what you can do, what your day-to-day life can feel like right now, starting today. For me personally, as a Virgo, that means that I'm taking out a whole weekend in order to deep clean, you guys. That means everything gets wiped down, everything gets bleached. That's just how I am. Something about that just mentally makes me feel like, you know, I like to have a clean space, but it also gives me a sense of control, and I really, really love that. There's not a whole lot of things that we can control in our life, but I can control the condition of my apartment, my living space, which is sacred and something that's important to me. But I mean, like, what can you do now? What can you start to do? Are there certain things that are taking up space within your life? Are there certain relationships that you're just like, ew, when you talk, it's like nails on a chalkboard, like I can't. Those are relationships that, you know, create some space and some distance, and maybe bleach those energies out. Go ahead and clean those things out. Go ahead and purge those things out. But it's all about how it makes you feel. If you're not able to digest it, stop forcing yourself to consume it. No one is asking you to consume anything that doesn't vibe with you. If you have an allergic reaction to a certain person, or an allergic reaction to a certain way of people expressing love to you, then that doesn't have to be your way, because it's not making you feel good. So the other thing is that I have to talk to you guys about work, because some of you guys are going to be attracting in big league clients, big league clients, and this is just the nature. The people that you might be attracting are these connections, this relationship. So it's not just romantic relationships, it's all types of relationships. But I'm definitely seeing this emphasis on work, because Virgo is notoriously known for its work ethic and its service to other people, like how you give your best services, the highest quality of your services to other people. And when we have planets like this with Venus, which represents, you know, values but also money, and things that are important to you, conjunct Uranus, sitting in the sign of Taurus, which loves money, which loves security, which is stable and wants that for itself. And then we have the North Node directly impacting sextile, this Venus-Uranus conjunction in the sign of Cancer. And then also looking at this, let me go ahead and scroll it down just a little bit. We have the part of fortune being squared off, sitting in the sign of Aquarius. So this could really bring in like a big league, high profile type of clientele. If that's the type of work that it is that you're doing, you could really cement and bond a really strong connection, a very awesome alliance. This is not one way, this is a two-way street. So not only does it benefit you, but it benefits them with the quality of the work and the service that it is that you are able to give, and the services that it is that you offer. So again, it's this bigger picture. It's connected through social media, it's connected to fame, it's connected to this bigger globe. There's the world is small, so you'd be surprised who it is that you can cross paths with and who you might be able to connect with. So this bigger picture that it is that you see for yourself, but it's those smaller details, those emails, how you present yourself, how you handle conflict, the quality of how you're perfecting your work, how you're perfecting your services to other people, that add up to this bigger picture. And it's word of mouth that spreads, that connects you to the right person at the right time. Not, like I said before, not only does it benefit you, it benefits them with the type of work that it is that you're able to provide. So I want you guys to put a pin in that, because it's written all within the chart. All right, so I'm going to end this on by saying this, that notoriously I have seen in my comments pretty regularly people saying, well, Jess, tell me exactly how to manifest under this full moon. I'm not going to do that. And the reason why is because every single one of your charts are so different. This is not me telling you to book a reading with me because I don't have the time and the space to do that right now. All of my clients have been booked up for more than half of this year. And I might open up space for it, but that's not my intention right now to do that. My clientele is mostly behind the scenes. So what I'm saying this to say is that everyone's chart is so different. And what I want you guys to do is to do some of this work yourself, this soul searching work. There are certain things, like I said, this chart is supporting you to know what it is that you feel, your vibes that is that you're feeling. Nothing is off limits to you. When you set this intention, or when you are working on setting the intention, and I have videos about how to set intentions all over my YouTube channel and link some of them down below. But when you set this intention, watch your feelings. How does it make you feel? When you are working on writing this intention down or putting down that petition, if it feels like it's off limits, if it feels like something that feels too good to be true, it's not that it's not going to happen. It's just this spirit, it's just spirit's way and your intuition telling you that it's not that it's not gonna happen. We just wanna take it a step back and we're gonna do these preparatory stages, this preparatory phase. So let's say you have this vision of, you want to set intention for your dream job, whatever that is. Again, we're gonna go back to that vision of, you know, working remotely, traveling to Tahiti, going to Bali, eating fruit every day, and feeding monkeys from your balcony, which is literally my next intention. Like, that's the next vacation that it is that I would love to feed monkeys from a treehouse somewhere, anywhere in the world at this point. Like, Costa Rica would be dope. Meet me out there. Let's work on setting the intention on that, right? So yeah, and then you're setting the intention, like you're writing it down, right? And then you're starting to feel like, okay, it just feels impossible. How am I gonna do this with my work schedule? How am I gonna do this because I don't have the money? As soon as you're trying to set that intention, you're met with doubt and resistance, and that is okay. That's not something that you wanna fight. That's the truth of your current situation right now, is that that is the first limiting thing that is stopping you from manifesting that. So instead of trying to jump forward, and this is just something that works for me, you guys, so to each their own, but instead of trying to jump past all of that doubt and trying to just hope and pray that your intentions are going to manifest, take it a few steps backwards, the smaller details, and say, well, I want more money. I want, instead of making $14 an hour, I want to make $30 an hour, or whatever it is. Or I want to have savings, I want my savings account to be $10,000 or $15,000, or whatever the case is. Set intention for those things and then open up to receive it. Those are those smaller steps that are going to help you again to get to that bigger picture. All right, you guys, so thank you so much for watching this video. Go ahead and feel free to hit the thumbs up video, but more than that, you know, I really appreciate those of you guys that share this video on your social media. Make sure that you are tagging @BahatiLife so that I can repost it onto my personal social media, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.